And here we go.
10.
Hydrogen burn-off igniters initiate. 7, 6, 5. Four-stage engine start. 3, 2, 1. And liftoff of Artemis 1. We rise together back to the moon and beyond.
The first time it was quite amazing to realize that, hey, we're shaking the whole ground, the whole earth is moving. And once you feel that rumble when you're sitting in the control room, it's a really good feeling when these rockets go up, and it's very impressive. My name is Reggie Martin. I am the ground controls chief at Kennedy Space Center. My favorite memories of growing up in Wheaton involved just being around my family. And so a lot of us grew up around each other, and so we played sports together. I went to Wheaton North and played football and baseball. One of the things I really enjoyed a lot was once wintertime would hit and we would go to Blackwell Park and we'd go tobogganing down the hill. We'd go ice skating and things at Northside Park. It was a lot of fun. I had a really good time growing up in Wheaton. When I got out of high school, I went into the Navy, and they train you to work on electronics. I was a fire control technician. So what they are the people that do the electrical work on the gun systems, missile systems, and radar systems. So I really enjoyed being in the Navy, because one of the fun things I got to do was be on an aircraft carrier. USS John F. Kennedy, that's what I worked on as a fire control technician. And it was a lot of fun getting to see missiles being fired and tested out. One of the things that I realized while in the Navy is that all the guys in charge went to college. And so when I got out of the Navy and started working for Fermi, a lot of the people there were very encouraging, saying, hey, you should go back to school. And so I started going to college at DuPage, working on my associate's degree. And I did very well when I was at college at DuPage. And so then I started going to Illinois Tech, worked on my 4-year. And when I finished my undergrad, Fermi moved me from being a technician to being an engineer. Happened to be down in Orlando, and I decided to go out and play a round of golf. And as I'm out playing, turns out I met this guy, and I told him I worked at Fermilab, told him I was an electrical engineer there working on particle physics, and he was very much into physics and everything, and asked me if I was interested in maybe applying for a job down here with NASA. And I was like, well, I'll look into it and see how that goes. He goes, well, they got a job fair going on tomorrow. So I went over at the job fair the next day, and later that week they gave me a call, and next thing you knew I was down here and enjoying the hot life. Historic Cocoa Village reminds me a lot of being home and where I grew up in Wheaton, because it has that old town feel to it, a kind of a little small closeness. So it has a lot of different architecture and a lot of different artistic impressions as you travel along through here. So it's a nice family-friendly place that my family and I really enjoy coming to just relax and hang out. When I was at College of DuPage, I remember the smaller class sizes, so it felt less intimidating trying to get back into college. The area that had the most impact on me, obviously, was learning the engineering, the statics and dynamics. My professors were very positive and very motivating. They're very more like the, hey, you can do this, you've got the capacity. That's also where I took speech class early on. So learning how to talk in front of others and present what it is that your findings are in your reports. And so these days I use that
extensively now that I've advanced further in my career. And so those are skills that I started developing and understanding at an early age when I was at college in DuPage. Now we're at the VAB and the Launch Control Center. Inside the VAB is where we assemble the rocket and get it prepared to go out for launch. So we'll roll the mobile launcher into the VAB and then we'll perform what's called stacking. We'll stack the SRBs onto the rocket and then the core stage, and then we'll load Orion on board and get it prepared and checked out for launch. Right now we're standing on the crawler way, and the crawler way is what we use to transport the mobile launcher and the vehicle, the SLS and the Artemis 1 mission, from the VAB out to the pad. My ground control team is responsible for doing the communications between the launch control room and the launch pad. And the launch control center is where we monitor the health of what's going on with the vehicle as well as the ground support equipment. And that's where my team sits and monitors what goes on 24/7 from the time we start checkout of the vehicle until launch. My entire career has been always learning and continuing to grow, so it's never been boring. And it's never felt like a job. The entire time, it's just felt like I'm going to have fun today and I really love my job. My favorite part of the job is the design engineering. I love the operation side, watching the rocket go up and seeing the product of all of our work, but I also love the journey. So the design engineering is where the journey starts. The Silver Snoopy Award is a very prestigious award at NASA, and it's given out to top employees within the agency. And each year they recognize the top 1% of performers. And so myself, along with other colleagues, came up with a way to implement IT security and industrial controls. And because of the work we did, we received Silver Snoopy for our work. My astronaut's name is Butch Wilmore. Butch is like my guy. And so it was very special when I got the call that says, hey, he's gonna come and present me with an award. And I was able to bring my family, my wife and my children came, and my father came. And so at that time is when I really realized I had made it as an engineer. And I realized that, hey, people really value my opinion and my input into the space program.